I'm Ilyan St. Hilaire, a Microsoft employee on the Forms team, and today I want to talk about forms sharing with QR codes. One of the interesting features of Microsoft Forms is the ability to share the form as a QR code. Now, why would you want to do this? If you have a place, a specific location, like a room, maybe even a bathroom that needs to be cleaned, or you want to provide, you want to receive feedback on a commercial location, one of the interesting things you can use Form for is create a QR code, put the QR code in that location, and then use Microsoft Forms to collect the feedback. Anybody who has a phone can scan the QR code and quickly provide feedback at the location they are in, or the location that makes sense. So let's take a quick look at that. So the first thing I want to do is hop over to my desktop here. And what I want to do is first take a look at what a QR code is. I'm going to take a look at Wikipedia. And QR code stands for the quick response code, or quick response code. It was invented in 94 by a Japanese company, and it looks like this on the right, like a pattern of black and white pixels. And it has these characteristic three blocks on the corners so that the camera software can quickly detect that a QR code is in the field of the camera. And then it can read the individual pixels to see what the code is. Now, the value of a QR code is also not only what it contains, but where it's located. So if you're looking for feedback on maybe a classroom or something that needs to be cleaned or a commercial location, by having a QR code at that location, you're kind of not only marking the data where to provide feedback, but also the location that that feedback makes sense for. Okay, and so what I'm going to do is go into Microsoft Forms here, and what we're going to do is an example of a modern suggestion box. Now, a long time ago at the office, you could maybe have a suggestion box, which people would write suggestions and put it in the box. Well, a modern version of this is to use Microsoft Forms and a QR code. So I'm going to click on New Form, and I'm just going to just mention Office. So this is going to be my Office suggestion box, and then as a thing that I want to do is just have text. So I'm going to remove the recommendations here and just select text as the question. Enter. Let's see. Enter your suggestions. And then I selected this as a text field. I'm going to put long answer because I want to be able to have people type in multiple lines if they need to. And I'm going to say require. And the reason I'm going to say require here is because it really makes no sense to offer suggestions that have nothing in the text field. So I'm going to require that be done. Okay, so that's done. I have my modern Office suggestion box right here. Very, very simple. I can pick different styles if I wanted to, put an office background, select, basically remove this date, put what I want here, but I'm going to leave it to the default, which is nice and simple. So this is going to be good for me. Okay. So now that I have my suggestion box, I can preview it. And this is the webpage. Anybody who wants to go to enter the suggestions just has a simple field and a submit. And on mobile device, you can click on the mobile icon on the upper right. And this is what it kind of will look like on a mobile device. So Office suggestion box, enter your suggestion, and that's it. Very, very, very simple. Okay, now I want to go and share this somewhere. So what I'm going to do is say collect responses, and I could share this URI or even the shortened URI, but that's not what we're going to do, and it's not really practical to type this on a mobile device. What we're going to do is click on the QR code option here. So I'm going to be offered this nice little QR code, and if somebody scans it, they get to the webpage that uh, to offer suggestions. So a few things I want to mention here. First, there's a download button on the bottom right, and you can click on this, and it will give you a PNG file, which is a image file of the QR code. So it says office suggestion code and box in the QR code. So I can hit print, and I could print this. And look at that, it looks pretty good. I can select my printer if I want to. And so I have a laser jet printer here, and so there's a border. But this would be what it looks like. And it looks very, very nice. Now, if you select other styles, then, for example, I'm going to switch here to this style, go back to collect responses, then sometimes you'll get this next poster, and it will give you different suggestions of how you can present this QR code. So here, this is a different one, but of course, this is style specific. You have the image, and then you can hit print, and I'll select my laser printer here, and then you'll have like a little white margin around it, but this is what it will look like. So pretty nice. And super easy. So basically in a few seconds, I can have a QR code that is good looking that I can print and put somewhere. Now, another few things I want to point out here. Now, you may be tempted, let's suppose you want to do something a little more advanced, like you want to import this QR code into a Microsoft Publisher file or a PowerPoint or something like that. You may be tempted to try to do a screenshot of this. So I'm going to do Alt Print Screen, hit the top of my window here to select a window. And now what I did is I just screenshotted the entire window. I can go Paint, Microsoft Paint. I'm gonna move my window around, hit paste. So now I've kind of pasted this, and now I can select the QR code. I won't make a big effort there, but here it goes. So now I've kind of screenshotted the QR code, and I can move it into a document. So I'm going to open Microsoft Publisher, and let's suppose I want to do something fancy, like add this to a menu at a restaurant. So I have my menu at a restaurant somewhere, and I add this QR code, in the menu to provide feedback. Well, one of the problems with taking a screenshot is that if you zoom in, you'll notice that the quality is really bad. And especially on print documents, the resolution of print documents is much higher than resolution of screens, of displays. So this is what your printer will see. It's kind of blurry. So what I would never ever do is take a screenshot of this QR code. That is a bad idea. Instead, you want to right click on it and say copy the image, and then you can paste it in your document. Let's try this again. This time I'm just going to go in Paint, paste the document there. Yeah, they're perfect. So now I have the QR code, I can copy it again, paste it into my Publisher. Or I think what I could do is I can right-click, say copy image, and then in Publisher, I say paste as, paste special, and I can paste it as a PNG file, and there he goes. So now I have my QR code. And you'll notice that now it's very sharp. Like it is really good quality, and I can put this on a menu, or I can make my own draw box here. And I can say, for example, feedback, welcome. And I can, feedback, welcome. We'll center this, make it really big, and you get the idea. In fact, you don't actually need to tell people that this is a QR code or please scan this with phones. Most people know that when they see this pattern, they know this is a QR code and they need to scan it with their phones. And so once they scan it, boom, it gets them to the page that looks like this, and they can enter their suggestion. Now, another thing is, if you're going to use it for things like, the bathroom needs cleaning or something like that, you may want to have the janitor or whoever is cleaning the bathroom instantly get notified when somebody posts a suggestion. So what you would do, I'm going to hit refresh here to see my form. I'm going to go back here. and then go into the settings of the form. And then there's an option here called get email notification of for each response. And so what's going to happen is that if somebody goes into a location, it needs cleaning, they go and they offer, they scan the code to suggest that this place gets cleaning, you'll get notification right away. Another one you want to do is probably hide submit another response. When you submit a response, or somebody submits a response, they can be queried to, do you want to submit another response? In this case, we probably don't want to do that. And then allow respondents to save their response. If it's something as simple as a suggestion box, you probably don't want to have that. And that's it. You have that done. Anyway, there's another thing I want to quickly mention, and this is just because QR codes can be kind of fun. So there's different websites online that you can use to juice up your, or make the QR code look kind of better than the default one. So the default one, looks fairly blocky and normal, but what you can do is go into the collect response page, shorten the URI, copy the URI, and paste it into one of these websites online that will build you a more fancy QR code. So for example, I can have different options here for the color, and so I can change that. I can put a logo, for example, scan me in the center of the QR code, and then I can do things like, there's various frames. Yeah, there's different options here. There goes the shapes. So I can do these nice little shapes here, and I can do these lines so that it looks kind of cool, And so instead of having kind of a boring looking QR code, you can have something pretty fancy. You download it and then you put it in your document the same way as you would otherwise. So again, this is a great place, a great thing to do for menus at restaurants, cleaning bathrooms, asking for feedback on a business, all things that are perfectly valid, good uses for using Microsoft Forms with QR codes. Thank you very much, and have a great day.